Got the stream started back up here. Yeah, I think we're good. Hey, yeah, we're good. We're live. Hey, hello. Good evening, everybody. Happy Friday. Thank God, right? This week has been terrible and disgusting and gross, and I'm glad it's over. So we're picking up where I ended Wednesday night. We're doing some Pokemon SoulSilver Randomized, which means I have no idea what's going to be happening here. Random moves, random Pokemon to catch, random trainer Pokemon, random trainer titles, just because why not? So we did one go-through on Wednesday. It ended very, very poorly because on the train or the fight against the rival, against Gold, I lost horribly. And this time around, we're going to try to do a little bit better. We already made it past that fight. We got a couple of Pokemon. We haven't lost anyone yet, but we've only caught three. I've had six catch opportunities, and we ended up accidentally killing three Pokemon. So, yay. My starter was Snowcone, which is my Glaceon. And the rival has a Palkia. So that's gonna be interesting. We're gonna see how that ends up going later on. Just trying to get some things organized a little bit on my side, sorry. Okay, we should be good. So the only other problem here is that we have three Pokemon. There's a couple of capture opportunities right up here. The Sprout Tower is here, which originally in SoulSilver is where you can catch some Ghastlies and I believe Bellsprouts. Might only be Ghastlies. It's just wafers like a Bellsprout, so that's why they call them Sprout Tower. And there's some capture opportunities on two routes out of the city, but I have two Pokeballs and basically no money. And nothing really to sell worth anything. So, and this is the first gym city as well, so I think this is the first gym city. I think this is Faulkner, the bird gym. Yeah. And I really want to bulk up a little bit before we... Battle Gym Leader, when did you? I haven't yet, no. And study... No, I don't need... No, I don't need your tips. I already know what I'm doing. Fine, maybe there'll be some freebies. But yeah, I need to find items to sell so I can afford some Pokemon, or alternatively, we're just... Oh. Oh, thanks, Lee. It's... I have chat up on the overlay now, and it's just terribly tiny for me to read, but thanks. I put a good bit of time and effort into it, and I'm glad it looks nice. Guys have like, yep, berries, that's cool. You're gonna tell us about trading, right? Yep. And you're gonna tell us about nothing important. Your former joining the group, you should have visited a union room, mixed records. Okay, so this is just all like, okay, no. I cannot do that. But yes, the goal is to get some money here so that I can catch some more Pokemon. I'm conflicted because whenever I go into the Sprout Tower, I'm going to have capture opportunities. And since it's a Nuzlocke, if I run away or kill the opponent, I don't get another chance to catch. So I don't want to go there until I get Pokeballs. Maybe I should try to hit the first couple of trainers in the gym here. That's probably an awful idea. Kurt. No, Kurt isn't this early on. I was hoping I could cash in some Apricorns for some new Pokeballs. Kid, you got anything for me? That's cute, but no. No, you don't. Alright, I guess let's head out here, see if we can get into some trainer fights without going into tall grass. Hey, are you a trainer? Nope. You aren't either. Oh! You gave me Rock Smash. Cool. Okay. You know what? Let's go ahead and teach that to my Gligar. He doesn't have very many moves. Poison Fang, Magnet Rise, Fire Fang, Double... I really don't like Double Edge. But do I want to get rid of it just for Rock Smash? You know what? Yeah, heck with it. Let's do that. Oh, no, wait. No, we don't want to do that, because I would need to use the move Deleter to get rid of it, and I don't want to fuss around with that on two different Pokemon. Runes of Alf. Oh no, what's gonna replace all the unknown? I didn't even think about that yet. Oh boy. Okay, Route 32. Hey, trainer guy, what you got? Oh, he won't let me pass without... Alright. I really don't want to go up to Sprout Tower yet. I might have skipped a trainer on the way into town. Let's go check that way real quick, and if not, we'll go to the gym. There's just no way I'm not right now. I think this bug catcher down here I skipped. Yeah. Okay, what do you got, buddy? I'm already worried. Oh god, he's got a team of four. Okay, that's fine. A level 2 Stantler. Yeah, we'll crush that. Yay for just plain old normal pace. Bonsly. Okay. Yeah, well, we're gonna keep going on. Bonsly's a rock type, so we'll just crush him too. Ironically, we meet him before the Pseudo Widow. Stunky is poison. I think he's only pure poison. I don't think he learns the dark type until he evolves. Yeah, let's try. Let's see how this goes. One attack. Bam. Nose pass. Rock psychic, but yeah, karate chop will do it. Oh, this is not psychic. Maybe that's probo pass. Oh, he's a rocker. I forgot the bug capturers are actually rockers now. Cool. Yeah, sure, why not? Destiny Knot. I don't remember what that item does. If the hoarder becomes infatuated, the photist. Oh, yeah. That. Okay. I don't. The volume on them. There. Get the music up a little bit. I don't know if that's gonna sell for a lot of money. We're gonna try, because I need cash. Physical attack and defense is still kind of not super great. Oh well. Has a target right in the middle of its face. It's like a big X. Punch here. Yeah. Oh. Okay, so the burn will finish it. Okay, that's... that. Whatever works. That was almost another level. Oh well. I guess let's go heal up. How much money did I get from the kid? I did not even look. Is that my trainer card? 33 bucks. Great. That'll buy me a whole bunch of jack squat. So I guess... let's go see if we can sell that Destiny Knot for anything. $100. That won't even get me a single other Pokeball. Even if I sell it in the... I'm not getting rid of the Iron Plate. That's a good stat boost item. Goodness. What does that sell for? So even if I sell everything else, I don't have enough money. Alright, I guess... go to the gym. We'll do one gym fight. We'll pray that we get a decent amount of money. Oh, are you kidding me? Alright. Now I guess we're going to Sprout Tower first and crossing our fingers and hoping that my two Pokeballs will get us a new friend. If not, it's gonna be real hard going. Alright, what's it gonna be? Oh, Shroomish. Hey, buddy. I actually really like Shroomish because he turns into a grass fighting type, which is such a bizarre combination, and I dig it. He's a level 5. Oh, goodness, do I even want to try? What does everyone else have? Does anybody else have something that grass resists? I could torment it. Poison Fang, Magnet Rise, Fire Fang, Double Punch. So, Dizzy Punch is 70 damage. Smash is 40. 40 damage with how much strength? 21. Less strength, but the moves do a good bit more damage. You know what? Okay, we'll switch into Pinchy. We'll throw down a Torment. Oh, that's no good. Oh. His attack sucks. Okay. Alright, cross your fingers. Oh, that wasn't bad. Yeah, I'm doing one more. I'm getting down to yellow, at least. Yeah. Alright, and he's supposed to be like an early game Pokemon anyway, so the catch rate on him should be pretty good. Yes! Oh my god. Oh, we needed that so bad after last one. Oh god, it's hot in here. Alright, so what are we naming our Shroomish? Oh, right. We have random evolutions on. He might not stay in his line, which is sad. Let's call him. Yeah. I'll just call him Billy. That's fine. Billy's a solid name. Let's see what Billy has. Okay. He has pretty good defensive stats. Actually, his hit point is pretty darn good for a level 5. Prevents its stats from being lowered. That's actually a really good ability. That is a super good ability. And he only has Bone Meringue and Aqua Jet. Those are decent moves, though. His attack's real low, though. But, oh well. We'll get him leveled up a little bit. Let's actually get him out of the tower here. Heal up, we'll try to get Billy a couple levels, and then we'll see what happens. He evolves, I think, pretty early, too. I think 16? Maybe lower than that. So, question. Do we fight... You know what? No. Yeah, we know what's back. So let's take Let's take him back a little bit. We'll do a couple of fights back here, try to get him a few levels, and then we'll go back to Sprout Tower. Oh, we don't know what's back here. That's different. Galay, that's a psychic fighting, I believe. Well, I resist that. Okay. Man, I actually would have loved to get the Glade. They normally have such amazing stinking stats, and he's a tier 3 evolution, so... Oh, that should be a level up, really. Okay. Just realized how abysmal his special defense is. That's gonna be a little problematic. In a Nuzlocke run, you don't want low defense attributes. That's all one way ticket to getting bopped. Okay, I also resist that. Okay, his attack didn't go, but at least his defenses did this time. Well, what's his hit point? 15 out of 29. Let's do another fight before we go back to the center. He should be able to, especially if it's another Glade. Oh, Gligar. Gligar only knows Torment and Comet Punch, so... That's Aqua Jet. That's abysmal. We'll do one more, and then if he survives, we'll switch him out. Yeah, I'm not chancing another one. Yeah, Pinchy, you can fight this other Gligar. Level up? I did not. I was not paying attention. No, because he was 5, we did 2 level ups from the first 2 fights, so he must be close. Must be real close to a level up. 3 XP. Oh goodness, he just barely missed it. Let's say we'll get Billy up to 10 before we take on Sprout Tower. Proper. Especially since we know we can take the Glades, and the Gligars, he's close. I'll throw out some more Aqua Jets. Dizzy Punch does worry me because I'm pretty sure it has a small chance to confuse. It's probably abysmally low, but still. That's decent. I'll take 1 point in every single stat. It's not bad at all. Next Gligar we run into should go down a lot quicker. Now the Glades we were handling so easily before. Oh! Wait a second. Oh! Alright, this route is, I no longer feel safe. Wow, so he was just throwing out just Hydro Pump and that other real bad move before, but ouch, Gunk Shot, that hurt. I think ground resist poison? I hope. Yeah, that was not a good hit to take. That sucked. Now I super wish I had the chance to catch a Gallade. That, he's got really good moves, and apparently his attack stat is pretty damn good. We're gonna go back and heal. Actually, you know what, maybe we'll just do Sprout Tower. Billy's level 8, that's decent enough. The Sprout Tower randos were level 5, so. Trainers are up here. Plus, hopefully, there are some decent items that we can sell off too. Uber. It's a shame Billy doesn't have any grass type moves. Ironic. Alright, he should be neutral to Aqua Jet because he's groundwater, so. Oh, well, that's. Oh, that was incredible. Okay, yeah. Okay, sure, I'll take a super strong dragon type move, that's fine. Lucario. Yeah, Boomerang should be able to hurt him. He's fighting steel. Oh, Meteor Mash is steel. I'm thinking Dragon Meteor was the dragon type. Hey, Meteor Mash is still real good. By the way, Hambone, you need more XP. that's the yeah, the kind of lightning bug sort of looking things. Fire punch. That sounds good. Fire punch is good. We're gonna pass on screenshot, thanks though. Oh, he's just a trainer. So the monks are trainers now. Okay. Let's put Pinchy up front. He needs some more XP. Actually, they evolve based on happiness, right? Pinchy's probably gonna be a while before he evolves. Aren't incense just breeding items? It's just some of that. Boost the power. Oh! Boost the power of grass type moves. Okay, that's not bad. I don't think we have any grass type moves, though. Nope, but we'll hold on to it still. Trainer Chow. Is that anything like a trail mix? Alright, let's do... Let's Dizzy Punch. And I'm glad these trainers are all super low level so I can get some XP, or this would be... real painful. You know what? He probably doesn't know any water type moves. We'll be fine. Oh, dang. That is a tanky freaking Omastar. Holy crap. 7 level difference with a super effective move and decent attack stats and heat. Survived. Man, I hope I find one along the way. Chimchar. Let's go with Cambo. Let's get you back out. Thank you. Thank you for kicking my ass. Okay. You know what, I'd rather get Pinch or Billy some more XP. Since he should level up fairly soon. Pink Scarf's power of... Oh. Well, we're not in Sinnoh, so that's going to be an item to sell. I thought... I could have swore Pink Smoke Scarf raised the power of normal-type moves. Apparently I'm wrong. I'm sorry, cute little baby Pokemon, but, we're just going to do this. Meteor Mash doesn't have great accuracy. Solar Beam, huh? Solar Beam, huh? Solar Beam, huh? Alright. Boom Rain. Okay, good. So much for the Solar Beam. God, these guys are not worth any XP correctly. Billy, how would you like a metal coat? Boost the power of ups, power step that moves, or I can give him the iron plate. That metal coat. I think I missed a ladder somewhere. I'm gonna have to go back down. Because you could see an item ball on the first floor, and I don't think I found it. Oh, Flaffy! That's bone meringue. Maybe Billy's gonna end up being my sweeper, oddly enough, because he's got a really good speed and... His attack sucks. I don't know how he's, like, doing so well, to be completely honest. You know what, whenever Gen 2 first came out, I did like Flaffy a lot, the whole sheep line, but I don't know why, but I kind of don't really care for them much anymore. I mean, they're still very competent Pokemon, they've got a real good move pool, and their stats are pretty decent, but like, just as Pokemon, they're not super favorites of mine. Now, you know what, no, I'll take it back. I still like Ampharos a lot, I just think that the Flaffy and... whatever the other tier is. I just think they're kind of... they're just... Hippopotamus. What? Hippopotamus. What the heck are you? It's gotta be a ground. Ground water, maybe? It's another whooper? Silver was up here. Gold. No, I'm sorry, jerk ass, I believe is what we called him. Because I'm still mentally a jerk. Let's see. Girafarig is normal psychic, right? So Karate Chop should be fine. What? Okay. Okay, his stats suck, otherwise that would hurt a lot. No! Okay. Man, I would have been a little bit more scared if I knew we were gonna kill him right there. All these freaking Pokemon with X's right there. Here. can she, I guess? Wait, what move did he just use? Ice. He just used... Okay, no, we don't want Pinchy. Snowcone. You haven't been out for a while. Yep, that's what I wanted to see. Alright. Pleasant Fang. These low-level Pokemon knowing really high-level moves. There's like an overabundance of really high-level moves. I didn't miss a ladder. I thought there was a hidden ladder somewhere up around here. I did get the item ball. Okay. Nope, not this one. Oh, how much money did I end up getting overall? 1377, that'll buy us a good number of Pokeballs. Okay. Not 10, though. Let's see if we can get enough for 10 so we can get that Premier Ball. Glad I ran into her in battle. I wanted to put Billy up front. I'm lucky, maybe we can get him to level after this fight and then we'll see who we get. So I'm pretty sure he levels. It's either 14 or 16 for Billy. Save and I completely forgot to. Oh, if that had been a crash, I would have freaked out. Oh, we don't fight him. Okay, he just uses an escape rope. I forgot about that. See, it's funny how they talk about not using Pokemon as a tool for war when literally Lieutenant Surge out of Gen 1 specifically makes mention of being in a Pokemon war. And then there's the whole thing in Pokemon X and Y where there's, like, a character that does, like, flashbacks to some gigantic, massive, world-spanning war that almost destroyed literally everything. But, yeah, no, Pokemon are just super not tools of war. Oh, we fight this guy. Okay. I love his eyebrows. Poison type, you say? X and Y were fun, but they were really ridiculously easy. So, and I didn't play Sun and Moon, but I've heard they're really good, and I didn't play Sword and Shield yet, but I'm probably going to be taking a pass on those altogether. But yeah, there's a big part of X and Y. There's, instead of being just like one subplot about, you know, the teams trying to take over the world, which is pretty much par for the course for every Pokemon since Gen 1, instead they have like a couple of different story arcs, and one of them is about this guy you see just like randomly throughout, like as you're traveling around, he just kind of like shows up and spouts off some pithy, like, some pithy, you know, Pokemon friendship rhetoric, and then we find out that, spoiler, which I don't think it matters much, he's some, like, 2,000-year-old immortal from this war that happened hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years ago, where the Pokemon, you know, like I said, almost brought about the whole destruction of the world, and he almost died, and his Pokemon sacrificed itself to do something and save the world, and made him immortal in the process, and it was real weird. Real weird. But it was also a really interesting way to take canon Pokemon lore. So, you know, I don't know, man. All right, let's pull Pinchian. Oh, that's not good. Don't you dare kill Pinchy. I'm gonna be very upset at Pinchy. Oh, well, that was a critical. We can survive one more of those. So we'll do one more attack, we'll potion up, and then we'll see what happens. I don't like that he keeps breaking down my defenses. So he has Spatial Rend and he has a Metal type move. Yeah, we'll potion. If Pinchy takes too big of a hit, we'll swap him out for someone. Yeah, we should be fine. Please punch! I literally live on top of a mountain. It shouldn't be this hot at 10:40 at night. No. No, Billy. You know. Nidoqueen. Okay, yes, we're putting out Billy. We are not self-destructing. See what a bone meringue does, though. Okay, yeah, we're safe. Even if she gets off a couple of crits, that damage was abysmal. Yeah, it's usually a good bit warmer down at the bottom of the mountain than it is up here, and I know it's been really hot up here, so I can only imagine it's... Oof. Then again, you live, like, in a farmhouse, right? So you got, like, plenty of shade and stuff around trees and nice foliage and everything. That has to help a bit, right? Alright, let's see if it was level 14. Nope, not yet. God, if Glitzen's a volcano, we're all in a lot of trouble. Berries, I don't really care that much. Oh, did he give me an escape rope? I think he gave me an escape rope. No, he gave me a full heal. You know what? I'll take it. When did I get Psybeam? Do we teach Psybeam to Hambone? Does Hambone evolve? Let us check. Alright, so I don't remember what he is, but I remember Spoinkus is unevolved form. Grumpig, level 3. Yeah, no. Grumpig's gonna stay a Grumpig. So let's see what his stats are. And then probably teach him Psychic. Oh yeah, his special attack is his second best stat, so yes, we are teaching him Psybeam. Let's ditch... I don't like the inaccuracy of high jump kick, so we're gonna get rid of that. Speaking of places to live, I've always wanted to live in, like, a house just in, like, a little, I don't know what the term is for it, but, like, where there's, like, forest pretty much bordering it on, woods bordering it on all sides, it's just, like, a little grassy cutout for you to pop a house down on. This area actually has a good bit of that, but they're all, like, really big houses and super duper expensive, so I'm never gonna have one of those, but man, good dream. Down in Claysburg proper, there is this really awesome house. It's got this, like, low cobblestone wall up front, just a little cutout for the driveway to go back through, and it's pretty much hidden by trees, but it is... Yeah. But it's, this really nice, really big house, but it's kind of like, it has a bunch, like a field of trees in the front of it, so you can't really see it unless you are, like, stopped along the side of the road and actually trying to look at it, but it is such a nice looking house. But probably was, you know, I'd imagine somewhere along the lines of half a mil. Claysburg has some surprisingly expensive houses whenever you actually look. We got this sorted out. We're gonna hit the gym or... Oh no! We're gonna see if... We're gonna see if we have enough money to buy 10 Pokeballs. And then we're gonna go down to that other route we haven't gotten to yet. And see if we can catch a new Pokemon. How much money? Yeah, we got enough. South. Do we also want to go to the ruins of Alf and see if we can catch whatever is replacing the, Yeah, let's do that too. Let's try to get a full party before we, jump into the boss, the gym fight. Guy, but I don't think I've ever actually played a game that has him catchable. Let's see, he's a water type, so let's try an Aqua Jet. Oh yeah, that did pathetic damage. We'll hit him with a handful of those. Cool. And that's where we're gonna stop and start throwing balls. You know what he reminds me of now that I'm actually looking at him? He kind of looks like a green Kool-Aid man. Like, the crown looks like the little spout at the top, and he's got the big round body. Maybe that's just me projecting. Maybe I just want some Kool-Aid because I haven't had any in like 20 years. Alley. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I feel like somebody I knew dressed up as the Kool-Aid Man is for Halloween. Is that how you spell Kool-Aid? No, it's A-I-D. Okay. Probably as soon as he evolves, gonna turn into something super duper different. But hey, for now, that works. Okay. Crush Claw. We're level 4, his stats are pretty decent. Power sub moves that have recoil damage. No. We're not doing that. I'm just rearranging some stuff to make it a little bit easier for me to... There we go. Alright. So, if I remember right, I go up here and talk to these guys, and then it lets us into the actual ruins. I'm not just a visitor. I want to explore the ruins. There's something special you have to do to make the, she's not wrong. You have to do something special here to make the unknown start. Or not. Hey, Marie. I'll take it. We need an electric type. Now let's just hope we don't kill it. Let's do an Aqua Jet because his attack still sucks and that's not a super high damaging move. Okay, let's do one more. Good. Alright, Alana, start thinking up a name. We're probably gonna catch this guy. Gonna name them a reap. Hmm. I actually have nothing. I'm blanking on something to call this. Bad Friday? We're just glad the week's over. You know what? It's a female, Mareep. In honor of it being Friday. I'll name her Felicia. Yeah, the week was pretty not awesome for me either, so I super get that. Okay, so apparently our unknown are just Mareep straight up. Okay. A shame we don't have 28 variants of Mareep. Let's see if they're worth any good XP. We might be able to farm them pretty easily. I'm doubting it, but let's see. You know what? That's enough that we'll... Or we'll go up the ladder, because I totally didn't mean to do that. Back down. Remember, I called off on Monday, and this week was still ridiculous and way too long. Summer weather, I like warmth, but it's this last week has just been way, way, way too much. Like, if it could stick to a consistent 65 to 70, I'd be pretty happy, but this, like, 90s at the top of Woodson is not cool. Hey, Billy's 15. You evolving yet? Not yet. 16. Alright. Let's put you up front. Get you some XP off of the gym trainers. We should be a high enough level that we can... I'm sure caves are very nice this time of year, but I don't know of any around here that have, you know, electricity and internet, so I will take a pretty solid pass on that. I'm a nature lover and all that, I am even more so a tech junkie. Maybe I should... I'm thinking about it. I haven't been on a hike in a couple of years. Maybe I should carve out a weekend coming up here and go take a nice hike. Maybe up at Trout Creek or... There's a bunch of pretty decent hiking areas around here. Preschooler A. Hey there, buddy. Oh. Huh. Pinchy. Throw you out. Of course you can. Great. Alright. Dizzy Punch. Oh, the heck is that? Oh, well. Great. Okay, thanks. Awesome. Are those its only two moves? It poison gassed me and it tickled me, and it has Twin Needle. Well, that's garbage damage against Pinchy, so that's fine. I don't think I have a full heal. Do I want to use a full heal right now? That seems like such a bad idea. Yeah, we're doing it. Mental note, pick up some antidotes whenever I go back to the store. Glad I switched out Kool-Aid Man, though. This would have been absolutely god-awful for him. Okay, we can probably do one more turn before we have to switch out to someone else. Man, I wish I had a Steel Type. They cannot be poisoned. Bring out Hambone, that's weak to bug. We don't want to bring out Billy, he's weak to bug. Felicia's too strong. Alright, Snow Cone it is. Let's hope G doesn't get poisoned. Oh no! Raichu's a jerk. It's exactly the kind of moves that we do not want here. Oh, come on! I didn't think she was slow enough. I also didn't think that lowering my defense was gonna do that. Well. There goes Snow Cone. I was really hoping that he was gonna last a lot longer than that. I remember, in this gen, poison stops dealing damage when you get the one hit point. Yes. Oof. If we had lost two Pokemon there, I would not have been a happy camper at all. Just the void? Or can you get more wallpapers later? Oh, I think you unlock more wallpapers later. That's right. We'll put her in the big Poke Center in the sky. Glaceon just always seemed feminine to me, even though that's clearly a boy Glaceon. Oh. Alright. So that means we're down one. We don't really have a really a good place. We don't have a place at all to go farm anymore. We used all our catches up, so I guess we're gonna go grind up a little bit so our next gym fight doesn't do that. Man, that sucks. Okay, this route back here was a little scary, but the Pokemon here were worth a whole lot of XP. What did that Gallade have that scared the crap out of me? Did it have high jump kick too? Now we know what Gligar has. He's got decent offensive stats. Let's try that mirror shot. He's got abysmal accuracy. I knew there was a reason I didn't want to stand against this Drifloon. If he gets 5 turns on the ramp, I'm screwed. Come on. And I used my only stinking Pokemon, or my only stinking potion. Technically, I can survive 2 more hits, 2 more turns, as long as... Okay, cool. That's good. That's super good. That gives me an extra turn for breathing. Okay, good. 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 Kool-Aid Man, you can not be in the front right now. I'm taking too many risks. Taking way too many risks for a Nuzlocke. Holy crap. I think Felicia Ball's pretty early level too. Special type attacks back, I believe. Let's confirm that. Heat wave. Exhausting breath from the foe to attack. It may also leave the target with a burn. Retaliation move that counters any special attack inflicting double the damage taken. Alright, we're gonna throw a heat wave out and see what happens. Oh yeah. He has Hydro Pump. Billy, get in there. Boomerang sounds good. Oh, come on. No. assistant. And that's actually a move like a ton of lines.
Alright.
Go heal and we'll come back out. I want to get both of them. I'd like to get both of them to level 10. Since that Raichu we went up against is level 9, I think Faulkner's Pokemon are around like 10 and 13, if I'm remembering right. The ironic part, I watch other people play Pokemon Nuzlocke all the time, and I watch them make like stupid boneheaded moves, like keep a Pokemon in way longer than they should against others that they, you know, have good type attacks against, and whenever I'm in the same situation, I just don't do anything different, apparently. Which is going to be neutral damage, and but his attack is low and rapid, so we should be able to. Yeah, like I'm bad about it too. Like I'll literally yell at the screen and say, "Why did you do that? Why didn't you switch out? Why didn't you use a potion?" And it's just being in the hot seat. You think that, oh, it's gonna be, you know, it's you, so it's not gonna, you're not gonna have a huge issue like that. You're not gonna get hit by a crit. You're not gonna get a super effective attack that's gonna take you from more than half life down to nothing. Damn logical fallacies. Okay. Felicia's special defense is not going anywhere. So she's pretty physically tanky and she's got decent speed, but that special defense is so bad. His attack's actually getting somewhere. Like, at first, his attack was abysmal, but it's actually been consistently upgraded the last couple of levels, so I'll take it. Never think here is really good for XP too. They're all either final tier evolutions or the Feast Blighter. I don't know why it just does really good XP. Come on, Felicia. Get some of this XP. What? Ow. Okay, Felicia, we'll give you one shot. Can you do it? Nope. Nope, you cannot. One or two more should do it for Kool-Aid Man. I'm tempted to see if we can get Billy to 16 here. Okay, that's fine. And a level one? Not quite, right? No, you got there. Okay, cool. Alright, put Felicia up front. We'll switch train her and try to get Billy up to 16. And then, 11:15. Maybe we'll go until midnight. Wanting to go down to self-destruct. I need to get rid of that. That is too big of a problem. Because usually the way I do it, whenever I play Pokemon games, I'll have, like, in the first slot is going to be the weakest move, second slot I put in, like, a status condition, third slot is the medium strength move, and fourth slot is the strongest move, which, in all fairness, self-destruct is the strongest move, but it is the very last thing you want to do by the way. Yeah, I mentioned this before, but, like, small organizations is something that, like, I get a little antsy about, and that's just one of those things where, like, I just have to have the Pokemon move positioned the right way or it's gonna bug me, and it bugs me that I haven't been changing them for this playthrough, but I also know that I have no idea what move I'm going to learn next, so it's going to be too much micromanagement to really want to mess with. Okay, so it knows Crunch and it knows Iron Tail. Iron Tail is half damage against Marie, because the electricity resists steel, and Crunch is normal damage. Let's try one Heat Wave. Do one Heat Wave, and we'll switch out. Yeah, we'll do two Heat Waves. We'll make sure that Black gets her with the ball. Marie. We'll make sure Marie gets her. Yay! Metal Burst? I don't know that move. At all. Thank you. Caesar retaliates against the foe that last inflicted damage on it with much greater power. That's interesting. Seems better than Metal Coat. Now, it doesn't specifically say it counters. It doesn't specifically say that it says retaliates against the foe that last inflicted damage. So I don't think it has to be the same turn. So I don't think it has to go last. And it doesn't seem like it specifies whether it's physical attacks or special attacks. So that might be just like a better counter. That seems neat. Definitely better than Mirror Coat either way. Bet you it was a signature move for somebody. I'm gonna look that up. Such garbage damage. There are not too many of those, and I'll have Billy up to 16. The Glades, I think, are worth even more XP. We can find some more of them. The Lickitung was about 90, so it was exactly 90, so. Should evolve, and then I think we need a grass stone to evolve. Breloom up. Wait, no, that's right, it's not gonna evolve into Breloom, it's random. When I did Gen 3, Ruby and Sapphire, I think I kept my Breloom until the very, very end of the game. I'm pretty sure that was a Gen 3. It's mostly rhetorical. I'm about 80% sure it was Gen 3, and then I remember debating whether I wanted to keep it or Nuzleaf, which was C-Dot, which was the little acorn, which turned into the I don't know what, and then he turned into his third tier was a grass type. It was a grass dark. What are they called? The Japanese. What do they call them? They were Japanese, more the long nose, flying goblin creatures. Oh, goodness. Oh, I'm so annoyed, I can't think of what they're called. because they're like one of my favorite mythological creatures just because of how ridiculous they are. Yes, I'm looking it up because I can't not. Tengu. I didn't even get to the list, I just randomly remembered it. It was a Tengu. So he started out as a little acorn creature, and then he turned into some weird thing as an intermediary stage, and then his final stage turned into, I literally just forgot again. Tengu. There we go. But I had a lot of trouble because I couldn't decide if I wanted him or if I wanted the Breloom line, because it was grass, dark, versus a grass fighting. But I think I ended up sticking with the Breloom. I don't think the grass dark typing really did that well in Gen 3. Buddy. If we were trained night and day to become masters of bird Pokemon, bring it on. That's funny because I can guarantee not a single one of you is actually gonna have a flying type. Preschooler Rod, what do you got? Stand corrected. That's a flying type right there. And he knows Blizzard? But Swablu's only got a fire type move that ain't gonna do shirk against a Swablu. We'll keep. Hey, it's not nice. Can birds growl? Pokemon continues to ask the real questions. Thing I'm super duper worried about. My first time through SoulSilver, this gym destroyed me. Like, I wasn't even doing Nuzlocke rules, I was just playing the game regular, and I got obliterated. I think they powered up his, like, starting Pokemon's power because whenever they did the re-releases for a bunch of these games, they shuffled some stuff around, like between Red and Fire Red, there were some changes. Between Silver and Soul Silver, there were some changes, and I think they raised his Pokemon's level to make the first gym a little bit more of a challenge. So this might end up being super duper bad. I say this because I was considering just starting the fight with Kool-Aid Man still being down some health, but after I thought about it for like 5 seconds, I realized that was a super bad idea. Let's grab some potions and maybe some antidotes while we're at it. You, heal me. Well, no. Cool, but no. About it then. Three potions and an antidote. We all take it. Bets. Odds are that we're gonna get through here without losing any Pokemon. I'm gonna say the odds aren't great, but let's go. It's got such traditional Japanese does. Okay, well now you're just gonna prove me wrong, because that's also a flying type, I'm pretty darn sure. So Faulkner's gym is still staying true to its word. Let's mirror coat and see what. I don't like that. Well, that kind of works. Did 10 damage. If I take a crit, that's gonna be it. So Judgment, I think, is Judgment normal type? Or is it based on the type of the user, maybe? Switch to Handbone. Wait, Handbone special defense is garbage. It's fine. We'll be okay. We've got lots of HP. Stop it. How weird would that be in the middle of a fight, just seeing a giant flying manatee go up and start tickling a pig? Back in for that. That's gonna be quad damage on whatever that fire type move is. The wind is finally with us. We brought out the grass bug type. Nice! His special defense must be just the worst. Okay, that went so much easier. Schoolgirl Faulkner, okay. I didn't even realize that was his trainer type. For pity's sake, my dad's cherished bird Pokemon. But a defeat is defeat. Alright, take this official Pokemon League badge. The Zephyr badge. Which lets me use Rock Smash outside of battle. TM51, I think that's supposed to be, I want to say Razor Wind? Roost. Okay. So originally it was Roost, but let's see what it actually is. Crush Grip. That's a move. You know what? Sure thing, Pinchy. Have a TM. Let's get rid of Splash. I think Crush Grip works for Pinchy. It makes what's the word? Aesthetic sense? Because you got the big claws. What do you want? Okay, sure. Wait. Did I ever go back and talk to Elm after? Okay, yeah. I was trying to remember if I talked to Elm after he gave me the phone call and said, "You need to hurry back, something serious happened." That was whenever we got the Pokemon Egg and, Gold broken, and we had to go back and give him the egg. Okay. You know what? The egg will... We can put the egg in slot 6. That'll work. That'll be a replacement for our poor sweet Glaceon. He said Violet City. Is this Violet City, or was it... Okay, this is... It said in the Pokemon, I think, right? Yep, right there he is. Cool. It's good to know that he thinks a 10-year-old out on a grand journey to beat the Pokemon League is the perfect person to hold onto this egg instead of, like, you know, all the adults. A Snowcone better be remembered for the durations. He was amazing. His stats were great too. He had a ridiculous physical attack. I'm so upset with myself. Okay. Thanks, random geisha. Okay, I can tell a couple things about this egg already because of this app I'm using. For starters, it has the ability Reckless, which is that move that Cacnea also has that means it deals more damage with recoil moves. It has a hidden power type of dark. And can we tell its types? Not this app will tell me the types. It has a rash nature. I think that means higher attack, lower defense. Attack. It has really good IVs for special attack and HP. Interesting. Okay. I can't tell what type it's going to be. It could be anything. It could even be an egg. Alright, so... we have Rock Smash. We can use it outside now, and I think there was something over here we could Rock Smash. Oh! That also gives us a field move that we can potentially use to find more Pokemon. Okay. Technically, I can go back into the dark cave from the last route and use that rock punch or rock smash to get through, but without knowing Flash and being able to actually see where I'm going, I don't think it's a great idea yet. Oh, nice. Did I actually get a miracle seed? Oh yeah, that actually gave me a miracle seed. Okay. It's a shame nobody has any grass type moves. It's 11:38. We'll keep going a little bit here. As far down as Union Cave, and we've got our first mom there. We already caught the cacne out on this round, so no more catches, but I need to grab this thing. Fan of Beedrill? I think I can safely say Beedrill was my favorite bug Pokemon from Gen 1. Bees are scary. I actually don't have a problem with bees much, despite the fact that whenever I was like... had to be whenever I was like 11, maybe 12, I had a wasp land on the bridge of my nose and it stung me like right at the tip. It hurt like hell because you have so many, because your nose has so many like nerves, nerve endings in it. It's real sensitive. I don't have a problem with these. Spiders. Don't get me started on spiders. I've had terrible arachnophobia all of my life, but basically anything else I'm not an issue with. Ugh. And that doesn't sound like a fun place to get stung either. To be fair, no place sounds like a fun place to get stung, but that also seems like a really bad spot. This kid gives us his phone number too and challenges us to rematches later. Swimmer Albert Ludicolo. It's fitting. Heat wave works. That'll be neutral damage. It's pretty good neutral damage. He has a really high special attack. I would like a little Ludicolo, please. Smooch him. Sorry, Ice type. Or wait, no, I think Smoochum's pure psychic, isn't it? Nope. Smoochum's still ice psychic. Defense is so high, the special defense is so low. These are like some... These are some Onyx tier stats. Really high defense, decent speed, garbage offense, and HP. I remember this, but whenever you go through here in the original unrandomized version of the game, you could find the TM for Roar. I have no idea why that stuck with me. Especially since I hate war. I think that's such a useless move. Hey, seems like good. I believe this was the Rattata replacement of this generation. Animation's pretty crazy too. I like it. Ah, Thunderstone. If I get a Pikachu, I can evolve it. I don't think there were that many Pokemon that evolved via Thunderstone. Not that I'm trying to think about it. Love that ground flying combo. Don't fight an ice type, but besides that, it's got pretty good coverage. Good stats. Pinchy's got a really good stat alignment here. Okay, so that picnic or that trainer up on the screen. She definitely gives us her number and challenges us to rematches later. I want to think her name is something like Jennifer? Don't ask me how I remember that. We'll see. Again, I could also be a basement later on, but I feel like it was a J name, like a janitor, a Jennifer, or Jenny. Yeah, pardon, Pokemon battle? I'm on the phone. Oh, alright, I'll accept your challenge. Let's be honest, she was just looking for an excuse to get off the phone. Please, I'm super wrong with that name. Oh, Gardevoir. You are a pure psychic type, which means Psybeam ink will work well. Oh, fire punch. Eat a punch. Didn't do much. I don't like Gardevoirs that raise their special attack. That makes me nervous. Stop it. How's Hambone special defense? His best stat. Okay. We'll keep going then. We'll keep fire punching. See if we can get a burn off. Before she crits. Thank you. He's a special tank. That's about all he's got going for him. Playing this game whenever I was like also 13, she was like my favorite because she would call you up every like pretty regularly and challenge you to fights. Plus, I always thought the picnicker sprites were really cute. Because she was always my favorite trainer, hands down. Keep going a little bit yet and see if we can get down to Union Cave. Yeah, there's a healing spot around here. There's the house of the weekday siblings, what they're called. Oh, shiny Ponyta. Oh no, I'm about to walk into another trainer. I don't want to fight him before getting to that weekday house. Billy! That's the one thing I liked about Platinum. I thought Ponyta's a really cool Pokemon, even back as far as first gen, but you don't get her until so late in the game that she's not a good fire type. But Platinum, literally one of the first, I think, three routes you can find wild Ponyta, so you get her early enough that she's actually really useful. I think she's the first fire type you can get outside of a starter. I wanted to play more Pokemon, more Platinum than I did. I think I said this already, but I got to, like, the second gym, and I just stopped playing. I don't really know why. No. Oh, come on, kid. Okay. Aw, buddy. Hey, buddy. That's not good. It's a fudge type move. Oh, and he's got good stats on it. God, this is a trainer fight. Oh, this is gonna be miserable. Meteor Mash, please do it. Okay. Worth pathetic XP for as much trouble as that thing gave us. Okay, you're not a trainer. You're just a deer. What's up, guy? Yes? I wasn't gonna say let's wrap up the stream here, but we now have an opportunity to do some catching. Yes, I am. I mean, that's actually awesome. Yeah, I'll take a lure ball on top of just getting a fishing rod. Alright, heal up. And then we'll see what we get out of the water. And we could potentially backtrack to so many other routes and do some fishing, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. Favorite Pokemon ever, both because the typing is amazing and because it's a penguin. Freaking metal water. Alright, what? Fire will be neutral, so that's an option. Pinchy doesn't have anything good. Handbone. Doesn't Billy. Billy has a fighting type. Let's throw up Felicia. We'll switch to Billy if we have to. Water Steel is such an amazing defensive combination. It's ridiculous. It doesn't have the most resistances and immunities in the game, but it has real close. Oh, come on with that. Okay, his attack sucks. If the user faints, the user's grudge to fully depletes the PP of the foe. No, that's terrible and stupid. Murkrow. Dark flying. Billy, you have a fighting type move, right? No, you have ground. That's fighting. Hambo. Hambo has Karate Chop. Hambo, you're going in. Wow, this guy's tanky. Defensive buff move, which is good, which means he's not getting a ridiculous offense, but still. Well, okay. Help. Well, we know it has a fighting type move. Super Fang can't kill me, so that's a good thing. It's really obnoxious, though. One of Execute and Executor's signature moves in Gen 1, Egg Bomb and Barrage, I think. Thanks for that royal beating. I guess we know what to look forward to whenever No, never mind. I was going to say whenever we fight Sudowoodo ourselves, and then I remembered we're not going to fight Sudowoodo because I randomized the static Pokemon too. So, Entei, Rakus, Suicune, Ho, Lugia. I think there were a couple more. Hey! Poison Barb, thank you. Love the weekday siblings. Oh. I was gonna say, I know somebody has a poison type move. It was Snow Cone. Seconds. Come on, you gotta try a little harder than that. Do you not know how fishing works, kid? There we go. What is it? What did we fish up? A Rattata. I was thinking of naming him Drowned Rat, but that's mean for a nickname. We're just gonna call him Carl. Carl the Drowned Rat. Alright, it is midnight, so I'm gonna call it here. We're gonna go back to the Poke Center, we're gonna heal up. Actually, we're just gonna go to the Poke Center and save. We don't spring healing. We took a couple of points of damage. But thankfully, we made it all right. And this was not flawless, but this certainly went a lot better than Wednesday's stream did. Alright. Well, thanks so much for coming by. You who are in the chat right now, and those that maybe end up watching this later, we'll pick this up probably not Saturday or Sunday. I don't think I'm going to be doing any streaming over the weekend, over this weekend, but probably next week sometime. But either way, thanks so much for stopping by. I need to figure out an outro, but either way, everybody have a good rest of your day. Stay safe, yada yada, all that.